Today, the topic of project management video of knowledge is very important for exam point of view. I'm 100% sure that it is practically impossible to do 200 questions without having question on one of this topic. The topic is perform integrated change control. Whenever there is a change request, it has to pass through this process. Otherwise, we will have scope creep at our hand. In perform integrated change control, we have change control board, which evaluates each and every change request. It decided on various factors, whether to accept the change request, deny it, return for information, or maybe delay it. But remember one thing that is very critical for exam point of view. Whatever the state you are in, all changes must be documented. And secondly, they must be communicated to the stakeholders. Now, another important concept is you don't give all the change requests to the change control board. No. Being a project manager, it is responsibility. It is your responsibility to influence the factor that are causing change. What are the factors that are causing change? And try to influence those factors. As a project manager, I will recommend that you check the impact on scope, cost, time, schedule, risk. And if you think that this change request must be forwarded to change control board, then you forward it. Otherwise, you tackle it according to your project management plan, change management plan. This gives authority to project manager. And while doing PMP, remember that you are a project manager who follow processes. You are a project manager who is a good leader. You are a project manager who understand each and every process. So let's go through these notes. It is basically the change control procedure or change management plan is the part of project management plan. Changes are accepted or rejected in this process. Now, if you put one change in one constraint, it will affect other changes. So you have to make your project management plan as realistic as possible. Okay, now let's see what we have here. Deliverables are produced in direct and managed work. Once those deliverables are produced, they go to quality control and you get verified deliverable. If those deliverables are approved in quality control, once they are approved in quality control, they goes to validate scope. And if they get accepted there, they become accepted deliverable. But along the way, if they are not approved, if they are not verified, then what? Then a change request must be initiated. And a change request can be preventive action. It can be corrective action, defect repair. Whatever the change request is, it is communicated to perform integrated change control board, where we already have work performance report from the previous process and we evaluate from those work performance report what to do, how to change action. So let's see this flowchart. Change request is initiated through various monitoring and control process, direct and managed work. It is recorded, its impact is calculated. And if we see the impact is reasonable, we give it to change control board. Change control board accept it. Yes, we have an accept. We have approved change request that goes to direct and manage work, quality control, control procurement, and we have updated documents. If it is not approved, we just have updated documents. So if you can understand this flowchart, I think you will be able to clear many of the questions that you are going to face in your exam. So let's review the process in another phase. You request a change, impact analysis is done, approved or denied. Then you implement change, then you review the report, how you are going to move it forward. And this is basically a change management process. So identifying the change that need to be occurred. And in short, only approved changes are implemented, then reviewing and approving change requests and managing approved change requests. These are the ITTOs. We have plans, we have work performance report from previous process, we have change request, EF, OPS. We have approved change request as an output, plans, document expert judgment, change control tools, alternate analysis, cost benefit analysis. Basically, we are checking the option, should we move ahead or shouldn't we move ahead, what to do. Now, remember one thing, change control board can be steering committee, can be composed of expert judgments, subject matter experts, even project manager can be a part of change control board. They review all the change requests. They see how to handle all those change requests. They approve, deny, return for information, or delay it. So you have change control board, change control system, change control tools. Combining all this with configuration management system, you have project management information system, which is important to understand for your exam purpose. The major purpose of this process is reviewing all change requests, approving changes, and managing changes to deliverable. So reviewing, managing changes, and communicating the changes, the process. Inputs are the same. Most important input is work performance report, which we make. And then we also have change request, and we have change control tool, data analysis, expert judgment, meetings. We decide what to do about change. Now we can have voting. We can have autocratic, we can have multi-criteria decision analysis, whatever your organization says. We have approved change request. Change request was initiated, it was approved, and it goes to direct and manage work, quality control, control procurement. We have outputs, we have change request status, entry is made, it is shared with the stakeholders, and we are updating our documents in this process. So this is all about change request, change control board. And I hope you understand this process. This is very important for your exam point of view. Thank you very much. If you found it useful, share it with your friends so that they can also learn about PMP and they can also clear it. If you have something to add or there is something that is does not resonate with your mind, do let me know and tell me how we can improve it. Thank you.